Hello and welcome to Sport This Morning. I'm Cecilia Omoble.
It's great to have you join us again. I'm Taya Salah. Right.
It's here.
The World Cup, the 2018 FIFA World Cup is here. We're no longer counting down in days, we're counting down in hours because the World Cup will be kicking off today between Saudi Arabia and host nation Russia.
Of course, no host nation has lost opening game. We'll see what's going to happen
today. About that.
And from 2018, let's go straight to 2026. This time around, you're going to be having 48 countries. 80 games will be played, 60 in the U.S., 10 each in Canada and Mexico. Of course, United beat. They won the rights to host the 2026 World Cup. Morocco had just 64
points. Not a game for Morocco. Better luck next time. Perhaps on the 6th attempt, they will definitely perhaps get to host football's biggest tournament. But congratulations to the United beat led by the United States of America. Also on the show, we'll be talking about boxing as well. Not about Deontay Wilder and Anthony Joshua. Not just there, about these two guys, Canelo Alvarez and Gennady Golovkin. The rematch is on. Yeah. Finally, September 15th, we will get the opportunity. Boxing fans will get the opportunity to watch that anticipated rematch between Gennady Golovkin and Saul Canelo Alvarez.
Okay, I can't wait for this one. Finally, is on September. We can't wait.
I can't wait for that.
It will be over, right? No rematch, hopefully.
Hopefully, it's a more conclusive ending. First time around, it was a very disputed draw.
Of course.
Right, some people felt.
What's going to happen this time around?
We'll see. We can't wait for that one. Fantastic days ahead for boxing fans.
Okay, well, head straight into the World Cup now. It's today, and of course, it's starting today. We all know the counting, it's all over. No more counting the days right now. We're just counting hours and seconds. See what's going to happen, what Russia are going to do this time around. But then, okay, now, before you get to see our faces, but then just enjoy what happened yesterday, a concert heralding the opening ceremony. All right, that's what we're going to be experiencing later today, just like a prelude to it. But then we have a very big guest in the studio. I mean, he's been to two World Cups. He's been there, done that, played in Spain, in Netherlands, for Nigeria 62 times. Okay, Finney, the judge is here in the studio. Good morning.
Sir, good morning.
It's a pleasure to have you.
Good morning. I mean, it's great to have you on the show. I mean, I can go, I can hard to what Cecilia has just said now. You played Nigeria's debut at the 1994 World Cup. You scored against Greece. Yeah. I remember, fantastic goal. I'll never forget that celebration as well, too. So we can go on and on in terms of the introduction. You played in Spain for a long time. You did some damage in England as well with Ipswich.
Yeah.
Right.
Yeah.
We can go on and on, but that's not what the show is about.
So Ajax, just of course, straight the champions, the remember?
Right. I mean, Ajax. So let's just let's pause on
that. It's the World Cup. It's starting today. How are you feeling? Let's start from there.
Yeah, really good. Actually, Nigeria is not playing today, so we just have to wait and see when they'll take on Croatia. But it's an exciting moment. Mm. We are all waiting for it, and we'll see what Russia will do today.
Yeah, we'll see what they will do. From what we saw in the concert and all that, last time, we know it's going to be another wonderful thing that they will do today. But for Russia, hosting the World Cup, the wait is finally over. It's starting. What are you expecting the opening ceremony and, of course, the opening game before we delve into the Super Eagles?
It's going to be interesting, but I don't think it's going to be an easy game for them, despite the fact they are hosting it.
Okay.
We know what Saudi Arabia can do, and just hope they win it, you know, so that it's good for the competition, but it's going to be a difficult one.
Interesting, difficult one. In case you don't know, the host nation, Russia and Saudi Arabia, will open things off. We'll kick off the World Cup later today at the Luzhniki Stadium. Let's just quickly run through the profile of both countries and see what they're about when it comes to the World Cup. That's their World Cup profile. Cecilia, Croatia and, I beg your pardon, Russia and Saudi Arabia, they're not like the biggest football countries in the world, but they've done well to qualify. Russia as host and Saudi Arabia are qualifying from the Asian region. We're going to go through the profile in a bit now. That's very, very important. Russia, they've been to the World Cup 10 times. That's how many times they've gone to the World Cup, so they have a bit of experience on their side. The first outing was in 1958. Last appearance was in 2004, while their best placement was a long while ago in 1966. They came fourth. Let's quickly move over to Saudi Arabia. Let's see what they are about. Saudi Arabia, four appearances at the World Cup. First outing was in 1994, like the Super Eagles of now. I imagine you met some of them players, right?
Yeah.
Fantastic. Last appearance was in 2006. That was in Germany. And their best placement was a round of 16 as well. So based on the profile, you want to say Russia have the edge.
Yeah, but football has evolved, and most of these teams or countries are catching up.
Mm.
So I don't think it's going to be an easy game for Russia, despite the fact that they've qualified for the for World Cup so many times.
Right.
It's going to be a difficult one for them, but I just hope they win it so that it will keep the tournament, going.
Exciting.
Yeah. Another thing is Russia says the last time they haven't won a game since October last year. I mean, they've been won poor form of results. For Saudi Arabia also, their last three friendlies they've played, they've lost all of them. So these two lowest ranked teams at the FIFA World Cup beating each other. You said Russia were going to have the edge. Can you give us a prediction or something?
Before we move on,
playing at home,
yes,
home support, it's always having the edge. I think if you look at it, you will not say they are far better than the Saudis.
Yeah.
But playing at home always helps, and with the home support, I think they will have an edge over the Saudis.
Okay. Yeah, he refused to give us a prediction. I see what you did there.
A 1-0 win.
Okay,
I think it's going to be a World Cup where we're not going to see
explosives at all. Fireworks. Okay, I'm expecting that too.
Okay, let's talk about the Eagles.
Yes.
Right.
I mean, they will be leaving for Kaliningrad today, later today. You know, the opening game is on Saturday against Croatia. But then you've seen the squad, we've seen the players, we've seen what the Super Eagles did all through qualifiers, we've seen the friendlies they played. From your own view, how far can they go?
They did so well qualifying for the in their group stage. in Africa.
Without
here.
Losing a game.
But it's a different ball game when you get to the World Cup. You're going to play against the best players in the world. Looking at the friendlies, I prefer personally to have results like this before going to the World Cup, so that it will actually motivate the players. If they have won all the games, they'll be too confident in getting to the World Cup. So losing a few games during the, or not having, we had the same, you know, in 1998 World Cup. We lost a few games to some clubs, Yugoslavia,
Netherlands,
and then we got to the World Cup and everybody were motivated, you know, feeling really good about ourselves, and we won against Spain. So for the Super Eagles going to the World Cup and with few bad results, it's not too bad. I just hope against Croatia they're going to come up, do their best, play as a team, and try to, you know, work for one another.
Interesting. Hopefully the Super Eagles can kick on Saturday against Croatia. Yeah, we're still on the Eagles. We're not going to leave just yet. So we have the opportunity of people like you in the studio, people that have been there, done it before. Then we have to make the most of it. You've seen the team as well, so everything they've done, qualifiers and the friendlies. And where would you say, obviously they have their strengths, but where would you say is their weakness, the most glaring weakness? Which area of the team would you say?
I would rather say they have to play as a unit.
They are not doing that right now.
They are not doing that. And you see when they go in the attack, it takes them too long to get back. And if you don't do that, you always have a lot of space in the middle. And you don't want to do that against the Croatians with Modric, Kovacic, and Rakitic.
Wow.
These guys are playing tough football. So we just have to, you know, make sure we get good grip of the midfield. With that, we have a chance. You know?
Interesting that you mentioned Modric, Kovacic, and Rakitic. I mean, that's a fantastic trial to have in the midfield. For Nigeria, it looks like Mikel is the man. I don't think there's anyone that's going to drop him. There's Mikel, there's probably Ndidi. It looks like there's one more spot there to be taken, and we don't know who it is just yet. But I mean, who would you rather see complete that trial?
I don't know. It depends what formation they want to play. If they want to play triangle behind, there's Mikel playing directly in front of the back four. If they want to do that, I would prefer Ndidi playing on the left side, the triangle on the left side, and maybe Victor Moses on the right side. We'll have to keep it close and play with wing players, or, you know, play with the diamond formation. Somebody playing in front of Moses and Ndidi. Wow. And try to make sure we make use of the fullbacks.
That looks like a very attacking setup.
Exactly. I mean, if I love what you just said, because if we can play like that, maybe we'll be faster, because it's like we're a bit slow. I mean, before the ball gets to the attack and all that, it's a bit slow or something. Is there something else that we can do in that middle of the park where, you know, the ball can easily get to the striker? Because Odio Ighalo seems to just, most times, is on his own, you know, up front there.
It all depends where we want to win the ball. Everything normally happens in the midfield. If we want to win the ball up, it will help us get quicker to the opposing goal area. But if we always win the ball in our own half, it makes it much difficult for us to get the ball quickly up. So what I would suggest, I don't know, I'm not involved with the Super Eagles squad, but if the coach is listening, we should try to win the ball in the half of the opponent.
Nearer to the half of the opponent.
Yeah.
That's online. That's it there. We're not going just yet. We're just going to take a short break. When we come back, our conversation on the Super Eagles' chances at the World Cup will continue.